We were all born into love and of love on a world formed of love by whatever loving cosmic force decided this third stone from the sun would be hospitable and loving to our kind of biological, chemical, and sentient life. Love is in the blessing of gravity and the Van Allen belt. Love is in the grace of the ionosphere and the atmosphere
and the radiation absorption
and the radiation absorption of the ozone
layer. We are breathing in love as we speak.
We are breathing in love as we speak.
78% nitrogen
in a mixture of 78%
nitrogen,
20% oxygen,
argon,
0.93%.
So the love we're shown by this earth has an air of benevolence about it that is enduring.
We can also speak about the love of our mother's wombs. How that love carried and nurtured us for 9 months, held us in its aqua boogie until we were ready to pop out and take our first breaths on this Mother Earth. In the cycle of this wondrous life,
the way you pursue so aggressive scientific equations, trust times effort plus lust times passion. So in lieu of your absence, I admit that I mentally DVR'd our holidays in Aspen. The details in the snowflakes, the grain in the cabin, Monet over the fireplace, the Everclear's absent. You stay, I look away so I don't telegraph the message. You know what's on my mind, you're telepathically obsessed with the way humans communicate. You illuminate the room like the moon harvest. Regarding the fact that I live my life as a starving artist, you support the guard regardless on his path to be a novelist, marvelous with the nourishment. I admonish the monogamous way you astonish me with your encouragement. My therapist, so much merriment, and so effortless that I should share your magnificence with the world. You already gave me so much, but I'ma keep it just for me. Just for me.
When it comes to infatuations, those are truly our own to behold and mentally possess. They have not been operating without us on a cosmic scale long before we were ever in the mix. We tend to become infatuated by choice, and the intensity of those choices may sometimes seem like love of a sort. But you can ask nothing more of an infatuation than that it merely tolerates your presence in the room. You can make yourself needlessly suffer for an infatuation, martyr yourself to that suffering, but that won't be love, because love would never be so indifferent to your loving or your suffering.